Good morning to you. Today is Tuesday. It is April the 12th, and I am your host, the Mighty Eagle, coming to you recorded from the Eagle's Nest here at Wake Up Central with news you can't use, or you can use, or whichever way you want. But I'm here with the Tuesday edition of Wake Up Call. As you noticed, I am a co-host short this morning. No wisecracks or comments about that. Grandpa is off today. He will be back tomorrow. However, we're going to take a look at the weather forecast for the Jackson-Madison County metro area. We're looking at sunny skies. As I look out my window here, the sun is shining through. It looks very nice. We are looking at a high today around 70 this evening, clear. I'm not sure what the low is. I think it's going to be around 50. All right, so anyhow, topping the news today, one of our former governors here in the state of Tennessee, Ned Ray McWhorter, passed away at the age of 80 last week and was laid to rest Sunday. A memorial service was held at his house in the front yard on Sunday in his home in Dresden, Tennessee. There was hundreds of men and women reportedly there. Some were dressed in power suits, while some women in their Easter finery, and then other folks who came to stand respectfully at the back of the lawn. There were elderly residents on their walkers and young mothers with their toddlers, and they just kept coming. Leaning up against the tree off to the side was a man with a long white beard wearing his jeans, t-shirt, and tennis shoes who simply said, "I grew up here. I've known Ned Ray forever." He was a man McWhorter would have walked up to and shaken his hand. Ned McWhorter set the gold standard for public service because he lived by the golden rule every day of his life. His life is a testimony to what it means to love your neighbor as yourself, said State Senator Roy Herron of Dresden. With his arm in a sling from a recent bicycle accident, the 46th governor was eulogized during memorial services in Nashville on Saturday with former President Bill Clinton and former Vice President Al Gore present, along with U.S. Senator Lamar Alexander and many others. Sunday afternoon was for his West Tennessee friends and family. A row of flags lifted in the breeze behind the podium as the wind cooled off the crowd from time to time. At left was the Tennessee seal, encircled in simple yellow and purple flowers, and a table holding his gavel, his cowboy boots, and his hat. At the right was a portrait. Before the service began, Senator Lo Finney, Democrat in Jackson, recalled that he had talked with McWhorter about 3 weeks ago. "I was discussing a specific piece of legislation with him. His mind was razor sharp, but it became evident to me that he knew exactly what was going on in Nashville." Governor McWhorter was a good man. However, when he was elected as governor of the state of Tennessee, I was only in the eighth grade, not eligible to vote. However, I did campaign very vocally for his opponent, Winfield Dunn. And had I been of voting age, I would have voted for Winfield Dunn, but I do believe that Mr. McWhorter did a very outstanding job leading the state, and my heart goes out to his family over their loss, and indeed I feel the state of Tennessee lost a good man. I appreciate his service to our community and to our state, and I just hope that many other people will look to him as an example of what a public servant should be and will take his example and take his lead. Anyway, Yes, I know this is not the normal, typical wake-up call show, but I did want to do a tribute show to Mr. McWhorter. I hope that you have fond memories of him as I do, and I wish to you the best. The weather is pretty. I hope you are able to get out there and enjoy the weather today. I'll be back here tomorrow with Grandpa, hopefully, and we'll have the Hump Day Wednesday edition of Wake Up Call. A side note here, there has been two, yes, count them, two Wake Up Call shows recorded for today. However, this particular episode will be the only one published to my personal Facebook page and the Wake Up Call fan page. Should you choose to view the first Wake Up Call that was recorded earlier this morning, it will only be posted on my YouTube channel. There is a link to that on the Wake Up Call fan page on Facebook. So, basically, the first show today was more of a soapbox. It was me voicing my opinion. Yes, I can opine, and I know what the word opine means. So, anyway, I hope you all have a wonderful day. I shall see you back here tomorrow with the Wednesday edition of Wake Up Call. Until then, I bid you a fond adieu. Whatever an adieu is, I bid you a fond one. In the meantime, hope you all have a wonderful day. Thanks for watching. Thanks for being a fan. Thanks for being my friend. And may God bless you.